are here to have good times.
Well, is the camera on?
No. Thank you for bringing that up. It is on now.
This is UnpauseIt, the podcast by a family of geeks.
You guys remember what UnpauseIt is, right?
Yeah.
What is UnpauseIt, Georgia?
UnpauseIt is our podcast.
It's our podcast. It's very good. We are sitting here on a Friday evening, and we've been looking forward to this day. How long have we been looking forward to this day?
For the entire life.
Since yesterday.
I'm with Willis on this one. Since about yesterday. Because what happened yesterday, Willis?
Star Wars.
That's right. We saw Star Wars.
All right. Yes. We should point out that we are sitting at our round kitchen table, and half of us have not seen The Last Jedi.
All right. The boys watched it, and the girls just...
Tomorrow morning, though.
However, the girls got a good night's sleep, and we get to watch it tomorrow.
Yes.
True facts.
So, but that is why we've been looking forward since yesterday, because we want to talk about it, but we can't talk about it until the girls see it tomorrow.
I want to do a little quick round table because we're going to use this as an introduction episode for what we talk about in the future. So first, let us hear from the patriarch of the podcast. He is on Twitter at underscore the dad abides.
I am the dad. I want to be like the dad, more like Walter, because I'm the only one here that cares about the rules.
Yeah,
I'm like, eh, and then the kids are like, yeah.
I don't give a shish kebab.
And they don't even know the movie yet. They are still young, have not imbibed the Big Lebowski yet. However, I'm wearing my bathrobe in honor of the first episode.
We're going to go around the table to the next person, which is the sauce underscore on Twitter. The sauce is the sun. What is your favorite Star Wars movie?
Thor.
That sounds about right. Anyway. That'd be kind of a cool crossover, I'm not going to lie, because I don't know what they would do with Thor. He speaks like he's from the Empire.
Well, that just happened because, you know, Disney owns Marvel and Star Wars, so technically they could legally do it, but it would be a horrible box office. What do you think about that, Willis? What do you think about having the X-Men with Iron Man?
Ooh.
I would not like it because X-Men kind of sucks.
Well, but Wolverine, dude. In my opinion... I do want to ask the sauce, Willis, over here. He had his first experience with going to a late night premiere showing of a movie. So last night, what time was it that the movie started? The previews
actually
first,
10:45,
right?
Because it was supposed to start at 10:30, but then they got lazy.
Yeah, it started really late, actually.
They got lazy.
So what did you feel about it? How did you enjoy that experience,
no
seeing
spoilers.
A bunch of other people there at the movie?
Yeah.
All the other Star Wars movies besides Force Awakens and The Last Jedi opened in May. So when we went to go see them at midnight, it wasn't freezing cold like it was. How cold was it last night?
It was very, very, very cold, and the movie was amazing, and science.
Okay.
That sounds like you had a fun time. We're going to move around the table to Furious Girl, who is Georgia, and she's got an angry cat plush animal in front of her because that signifies her angry cat face.
It's called a grumpy cat.
Grumpy cat. So, how are you feeling about seeing Star Wars tomorrow?
Happy.
Now, I wanted to talk about when we saw The Force Awakens. You sat on my lap for the latter part of that during a very crucial scene.
Who's your favorite character in Star Wars?
Darth Vader.
It's not a scruffy looking nerf herder.
It is, isn't it? It's Han Solo, isn't
Han
it?
Han Solo is my second favorite now.
You guys did get to watch The Force Awakens before you went to see the movie. How crucial is that, do you think? Which I think it'll play into what
it helps. If you're the guy or girl that likes to go to the movies and you watch Star Wars once in a while, maybe you should watch The Force Awakens again before going to see The Last Jedi, because it ties directly into it.
As a family, we've watched it many times, so I feel fairly confident in the fact that I will know what's going on. I will move to the last person in this circle, which is myself. And
your handle is?
Lady Disdain, and it's with a Y instead of an I in Disdain, because, well, somebody else had the other
My sweet Lady Disdain.
Lady Disdain. we're planning on doing this podcast. We're going to cover many things, but we are going to be a little bit organized about it, but fun. Dad talked about movies that come out in May. Something is coming out May 4th of 2018. Do you remember what movie that is?
Infinity Wars.
That's right.
The Gauntlet.
Right.
That's right. That's right. We're going to actually see Thanos in action against the, everyone.
On May 4th. I think that we should play the trailer, like, right here.
What were you going to say, Georgia?
That the Dead Abides is wearing Darth Vader.
I am wearing my, Darth Vader Sugar Skull shirt.
I do want to come back to the Infinity Wars trailer to get the kids' perspective. Now, Georgia, we might need to rewatch it because I've only seen it once, Georgia, in defense of you. So I don't remember. Willis, do you remember any part of the trailer where you're like, oh my gosh?
Thanos has an Infinity Stone to his gauntlet. Starts glowing.
Right? I think my favorite part is when get this man a shield and Captain America Cap comes in.
Bearded.
He's got a beard and he is looking like, I'm not messing around. I'm older. I'm wiser. Let's get this done. Now, when there's a new Avengers movie that comes out, what do we usually do if we have time?
Watch all the others in order and then watch it. But that never happened before in our entire lives.
Well, the more they come out with, the more movies they do, it gets a little bit more to be challenging. So what we're going to do, a rundown of all the Avengers movies. So what's the first one?
Captain America.
No.
First release. He brings up a debate. I have a list.
Is it in your cast?
No, it's not in my cast, in my broken thumb cast. But the list is of chronological order of release, mm-hmm. of which movies were released when. And then the other list is chronological order of events in the movies. Mm-hmm. So Captain America, the first Avenger, then happens in World War II.
Yeah, so in that universe, that would be first.
Right. But Iron Man was the first one to be released, directly mm-hmm. followed by... Incredible Hulk.
So I think what we're going to do is we're going to watch these movies in order of when they were released.
And that's what we're
going to do. So the first one, Georgia, is what?
It's Iron Man.
I still question
Tony Stark.
It's Iron Man. Iron Man, Hulk, Thor.
So we're going to review the movies in order of when they were released in the theater. So Iron Man will be first. And go ahead, Willis, what do you got?
I think we've been talking about the same thing, we should change the subject to video games.
That does bring up a good point, because we're not just going to talk about Avengers movies. We're also going to talk about video games, because we have consoles here that we play a lot. We're going to talk about anime stuff like Avatar and things like that. This is the UnpauseIt podcast. We have four people who are regularly going to be on the show. And we feel like we have a good spread because from oldest to youngest, I am Lady Disdain and I'm 43. Then we go to the Dad Abides, who is 41.
41.
Do you know how old you are?
Not anymore.
No. Then we go down to the Sauce, which is Willis, and you are?
13.5.
You're 11 right now. You're not 13.5. I refuse to believe it. And then, last but definitely not least, we have Georgia Furious Girl, who is...
9.
Right. We're going to talk about all that stuff.
There's going to be a segment of our podcast called...
Half Hour Screen Time.
Right. I was waiting for you guys to do it, because that was our, brainstorming. So Half Hour Screen Time be your video games that you do on a weekly basis. We limit you kids to that half hour of... just play screen time, because you get too much screen time as it is.
Yeah, and that's on weeknights because, I got home.
I think on weekends, we should have our screen time. Yes.
You guys tend to get more. If you didn't realize that, maybe you don't.
You get much more screen time on the weekends.
However, half hour
screen time does apply to school nights and even weekdays in the summer, because we want you guys to experience everything else besides just everything.
So Willis, this last week... what did you spend your half-hour screen time on the most? What was your primary choice?
Zelda. I didn't actually spend too much
time. Zelda Breath of the Wild on the Switch, right?
Yeah. I haven't actually used my half-hour very much.
Well, there was a couple of days you did not.
You did get, 2.5 hours last night because you were watching The Last Jedi. Georgia, what have you been spending your half-hour screen time on this week?
Stack the States.
Is that
Stack the States.
Online. Oh, Stack the States?
Yes.
Gosh, you guys have had that app for a
It's a geography
time.
App game that
we've
she loves.
Had we've had that for years.
Yes. It's been on our iPad. Like, I think that was one of the first game apps we downloaded.
Yeah.
Yes, and I love it still.
Lastly, I want to let everybody know that you can write us. You can also check us out online, unpauseit.com. We have a Facebook page, UnpauseIt. We have a Facebook group, UnpauseIt. And we have a Twitter account called UnpauseIt. And you guys can find our address there. If you guys have stuff that you want to send us, like if you have your favorite ideas for Comic-Con costumes, maybe you want to tell us your favorite character, maybe you have a series you'd like us to review in the future that we haven't thought about or mentioned.
Right. If there's a family suggestion that you want to do on your own, but you're afraid that it has too much violence or it's scary or something, maybe we have watched it as a family. We can tell you it's safe or not.
That's right.
It's a whole family experience. And we're going to vary this because the kids have not a half hour screen time attention span, a half second attention span sometimes. And we're going to have more podcasts that'll be the adult-themed Marvel shows on Netflix.
That's right.
Maybe going through a Tarantino roundup. Maybe we'll have a Tarantino month where we just go through all the Tarantino movies.
Without you.
Without the kids.
I know. Maybe you guys will do your own stuff without us.
Yay!
Right.
I'm looking forward to talking about Infinity Wars because it's new. But I'm thinking that I'm mostly looking forward to talking about Thor.
Nice, Thor
yes.
Ragnarok. Good choice.
How long will normal podcast be?
It's going to kind of vary.
Between 30 and an hour.
Now, there might be movies, though, that we're just like, we are on a tear, and we need to talk
right.
about it, because there's a lot to unpack.
So that's why we're writing it down. Which one would you like to talk about most, Georgia?
Doctor Strange, because it's my all-time favorite, and it just happens to be a Marvel movie.
Right.
That is a pretty good choice.
It's kind of weird, because Doctor Strange kind of has the same kind of things as Link, like Zelda Breath of the Wild and stuff. And besides, it has really cool effects.
It does. It has a lot of
magic.
We'll
have to talk about that, because I have not played. I am the only one at this table that has not played Zelda. So I won't know what you're talking about.
I barely played it ever.
The one I want to talk about most is Captain America the First Avenger.
Not Winter Soldier. Really?
Right. Because it's a war movie. First and foremost, before it's a Marvel movie. And it brings everything together. It's what sets up the Avengers and how he comes through. But Captain America is that constant in there where his arc changes the entire feeling of those Avengers movies. And it leads to Winter Soldier and Civil War. So those three are the best.
Actually, this is a great segue from what you just talked about. The data bytes mentioned that Captain America pretty much is what gets the whole thing rolling, which leads to my movie that I'm most looking forward to, The Hulk. Because there would be no Hulk had there not been Captain America, because they attempted to make another Captain America when they were developing The Hulk. Anything else you'd like to leave us with before we
your
sign
final
off
shot?
Evening?
I like Minecraft. Can I go play Zelda?
Yes, you can. And good night from the UnpauseIt podcast.
The UnpauseIt podcast. Stay tuned for more. We're excited to be here with you.
Comment down below if you can.
Play on.
Follow UnpauseIt on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube, or visit us online at unpauseit.com.